consummation, God's plan of salvation. In the absence of the resurrection, the birth, the life, and the death of Christ would have meaning. It will have no meaning. I mean, God's plan will not be completed. But these powers were overthrown. These powers, principalities and powers and the might and dominion were overthrown by our Lord Jesus Christ. And he has been enthroned far above them. That's what the Bible says. So if he has been enthroned far above them, and he is the head of the church, and Jesus is far above the powers and dominions, and we are the body, then naturally we have also been enthroned far above the powers and the principalities and dominions and authority. And that is what we can do. I told you, you have to know what you can do. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Thus, we have authority. And the source of our authority is found in the resurrection and the position of Jesus Christ. Because the resurrection and the position of Jesus Christ is the same as our resurrection and our position. We are resurrected and seated. And because we are resurrected and seated far above all principality and powers and dominions and might, we have authority over those forces of evil. And if you believe you have power, you have authority over those forces of evil, put your hands together for Jesus Christ. The church has the authority of Christ backed by the power of Jesus Christ. Because power and authority are two different things. Sometimes they are used interchangeably. But the Greek for power is dunamis. And for authority is exousia, right? So, yeah, let me give you an example. Ghana police has his way of stopping cars.
Mm-hmm.
And the American police also has his own way of stopping
cars.
The police stands in front of the cars and raises. Now, American police comes from behind the car and throws light or something. The way you know that the way you will.
No, the blue siren. Siren. The blue the siren.
See, so the policeman has no power to stop that machine. But he has the authority to stop the machine. You understand me? So the American police has authority backed by the U.S. government to stop you when you want to stop. And so that is what it can do. That is what the resurrection has produced in your life. If you don't know it, that is why Paul said from the beginning that we have to have knowledge of what the revelation has to do. And, well, we can say that the first two, raised together with him and sit together with him, is spiritual, because, you know, don't say, I mean, it's intangible. But you can exercise authority over the devil when he tries to mess up with you. Is the enemy messing up with you? Who is messing up with you? The devil, who is messing up with you? I don't think I can call it. Messing with you, I'm not messing up with you. I don't mess. The devil is messing you up. If the devil is messing you up, or messing up with you, or whatever, you have to.
Charlie,
you have it, you cannot exercise it. If you don't know, you have it. You can tell me you don't know how to pray. I'm joking. But you can tell me you don't know how to exercise it. It's like your child knows that you're doing the job. What? Child, you're not going to child, not going to do it. You're not going to do it. Is that where? The child obeys, right?
Yes.
And goes away. It means that you have exercised the authority that you have as a parent. And I'm telling you, I'm not telling you, but the word of God is telling you that no matter who you think you are, because of the revelation of Jesus, you have authority backed by the power of Jesus Christ.
Yeah? Amen.
To drive out the principalities and the powers and the might and the dominions and every name that is named, everything that has a name, you have an authority over that thing.
Amen.
Amen.
And then you have authority that now. So you can speak that sickness in your body. And it will obey you. Jesus says, Behold, I give you power. But that power there is not dynamis. That power there is exousia. Exousia means that I give you authority to tread on serpents and
scorpions
and over all the powers of the enemy and nothing. Say nothing.
Nothing.
Say yes.
Nothing.
Nothing shall by any means hurt you.
Amen.
So if you have Jesus saying, why are you afraid? Why are you afraid of the devil? Why are you afraid of the principalities? Why are you afraid of the powers and the might and the dominions? Why are you? So if the authorities are under the head, like I said, who is Jesus? The Lord said to the Lord, sit down on my right hand until I make your enemies the footstool of God. So right now, God has made Jesus Christ's enemies the footstool of his feet. But what you don't know is that Jesus' enemies are your enemies. And your enemies are Jesus, because it's the same group of demons that are opposing you. And if Jesus is the head and he has the demons under his feet, then the body, which is the church, has demons under his feet.
Amen.
That is the equation. Okay. If more,
let's divide.
If less,
more divide.
So it means that as you speak there right now, those demons are under your feet. No, no, no. But it's because you don't have the faith to use the authority, that's why the devil is messing with that. So I'm saying that if you believe that your enemy is under your feet, what do you do with him? What do you do with him? You can't say it because you are afraid of the enemy.
You will crash.
You are afraid of the enemy. You are afraid of the principalities. But knowing that they can cause you no harm, but you can exercise authority over them, you can say to them, you can say to that mountain, move, and it will obey. So now we are going to do that special exercise. By faith, we believe that whatever has become an enemy in your life, right now, by virtue of the resurrection, and by virtue of our procedure, and who we are, and what we can do, we can deal with that situation right now.
Amen.
You believe that?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, so be on your feet.
Is that the word to be? You are going to war with enemy, and this is the way you rise up and go. If I told you, I will get the whole
Chale.
The members are told to check in. Okay. And let me tell you, when you see the type of guns some people are holding,
hey. Kafumbe.
Then you know that the devil is finished. The type of bazooka they are having. But they have been firing all the time, and the devil is not there. It's because they are not doing it by faith, and it is because they are not using authority. Let me tell you, you don't see the devil running away, but if you see the devil, the demons running away at your command, you realize that you're not a small one. You are something in Jesus Christ. So, are you ready to crush?
Yes!
Are you ready to crush the devil?
Yes!
The demons, the principalities,